Hey, hello everybody. Let me do just a quick video. You know, because you know, my intention is always try to educate people how to invest. It's not how to trade. You know, because how to trade is 99% know how to do and 99% lose money, right? Because they have their own conviction, they have their own thesis, and they only apply what they learn, you know, through the market education process. And what usually they learn? Graphic patterns, Elliott wave, you know, and etc. But they never, you know, the dealers never teach people, you know, how to invest, right? You guys, you see a bunch of books, Benjamin Graham, you know, that's really good books that nobody use as your Bible. They always use, you know, big trades book, you know, to do what, you know, they want. They create like their own thesis how to trade, and 99%, you know, lose money in the market. Why am I doing this video? Because, you know, my intention is always, like I said, educate, and especially, you know, educate how to be profitable. Because at the end, we can study, you know, the book, the graphic, you know, up to 1 in the morning, but at the end, we never know what's going to happen. Because, you know, the flow 99% give you a visibility what's going to happen. But remember, it's dealers against dealers, right? I work in one of the biggest treasury banks in Brazil. That's called the BBM. And the family owned by the owned those this bank was they are billionaire. And at some point they commit a mistake in a dollar operation. And they almost bankrupted. And remember, they are treasury banks. They are a bank that provide liquidity to the market, but they commit a mistake. Remember, the market, you know, the book is dealers against dealers. And in some point, we don't know who you win. So, why, you know, I'm doing this video? You know, because, you know, it's the way that I'm seeing people are trying to express themselves through the open group, through the Twitter, through between friends, and etc. I use like Chris again as a reference because you know he gave you guys a very important advice, and I guess it was yesterday. You know, basically, and he did a amazing trade last week. Maybe you guys didn't realize that. You guys noticed that when we bought puts, remember, Chris also bought puts. But in some point, he started to take profit from the market, but he didn't close all the puts that he bought. I went off the market. I closed all my puts because I trade like gold. I trade, you know, as I will explain you guys, right? But what Chris did as well, he thought that, you know, the bottom supposed to be in, and he bought calls, but he never sold his puts. In some points, you know, the his calls all closed worthless, or he was roll over to another date, but he never closed the puts. Do you know how much money he lost? Nothing, zero. Zero. He was really profitable with the puts that he bought. He keep orders, you know, to protect his score. This, like I call, a safe way to invest. You know, he play as a dealer because dealer never play uncovered, never play unsaved. Dealers all the time ahead. If they are long gamma, they are short to future. If they are negative gamma, they are long to future. They are always hedge. The only persons that lose money in the market are retail. Because in retail, remember, CTAs are retail. Why? Because in retail, all are perm bears or are perm bulls. If you see a drawdown, they are fucked because they are always long. If you see a melt up, a squeeze, they are fucked because they are always negative delta. They are always, you know, how can I say, bearish. So, when you guys in this market, why I left, you know, SPX, annual graph open? In this market, in this type of pattern, somebody saying to me that we are in a very good yard to buy right now, for me is craziness. Since 2000, let's get 2008. Since 2008, we have 608% up, right? We didn't have any, and we have only a 50% drawn down. How come a person come to me and said, "Oh, now is a very good risk reward"? It is not, guys. We have how look if only analyze bullish bands. I'm not talking that market you crash. You know, I'm not talking that, you know, the ball is in. But I'm just trying to show you guys that nowadays the market's not safe for bulls or even for bears. Because we don't know the bottom and also we don't know the top. Just look at the Bollinger Band, look, you know, the amplitude of the movement that you have in this shit. Look, you know, how the EMAs spread are so wide. Between your EMA 8, that's 3,943, and compare with EMA 20, that's 2,800. Compare with the middle line of the Bollinger Band, that's 2,400. And compare with the EMA 50, that's 1,717. Remember that those EMAs are supports. So we don't have any like risk reacts, you know, to play safe right now, uncovered, unhedged. So I really loved it when Chris came and said, especially yesterday, the safe way to play is a straddle. And that's the most correct advice. Even the CFAs, you know, the financial advisors never come to you and said, "Oh, let's invest in this, but let's protect with this hedged like this." Because they want to sell, you know, products in the banks, because they want to receive the 5%. They were trained, you know, to make banks be profitable, not retail be profitable. Okay? Nothing in this environment, you know, have like a very good risk reward playing longs. Just look at the graph and look the spread between supports. Okay? The most safe thing in the market is to play a straddle, is to be always hedged. Okay? How do you hedge? Especially for those that play options. If you bought a call, for example, a 90 days call, protect yourself buying a 30 days put. Because if you see a crash, if you see spike imply volatility, the 30 days put will pay higher premium than 90 days call. Okay? Because the implied volatility and also according the volatility skill, right? The puts will be paid more premium than the calls. especially like long contracts. So you are playing long, but you are hedged. So in sometimes, you know, in the majority of the times, if market crash, if market keep going down, the 30-day put, you pay much more premium than the 90-day call. And you are covered. So since you know you see the market you start to revert tendency, you can start to sell the puts and take as much profit as possible. So this is the safe way how to play. Set up like a 101 straddle. You can, you know, set up like a 5-1 straddle. You can set up like a 3-1 straddle. I can be like 5 longs, 90 days, and I can have like 3 negative deltas, 30 days. If you know the movement continued, I'm hedged. You know, I have my insurance, my 30 days insurance, because if the volatility spike, I will receive much more premium in those 30 days put contracts than my 90 days call contracts. I will be protected with my long position. Zero DT is not a protection, guys. Zero DT is a casino. So, you know, my goal is to try to educate you guys how to invest, you know, how to create goals, because the market doesn't have sentimental, doesn't have bias, and doesn't have greed. Retail has sentimental, retail has greed, and retail has bias. You guys need to be like the market. Remember, who operate the market are machines that know how to calculate premium better than us, because their mathematics behind, you know, the code can process trillions of information in nanoseconds. And we cannot do that as a human beings. Machines doesn't have bias. Machines doesn't have a sentimental. Okay? Take care, guys.